Good morning, students. Good morning to all. And last day we have studied about the World Bank and the objectives of World Bank and the functions of World Bank. So today also just we will remain about what we have studied and we will go to the new concepts. So last day we have studied the World Bank's lending procedures and what procedures the World Banks are lending the financial assistance to their member nations. First one, the loans out of its own fund. So the World Bank always has its own fund abundantly. So from this own fund, it will be lending to their member nations. Next, from the borrowed capitals. So the World Bank also has some of the amount of capitals for the purpose of borrowed. Next, loan through the foreign capitals. So it also has the foreign capital investments. So from these foreign capitals also it will be lending the money for their member nations. So today just we will go to the functions of World Bank. Functions of International Bank for Rural World Development. So the World Bank performs the major role of providing loans for development works to member countries, so especially to underdeveloped countries. So this organization is always providing the many financial facilities to their member nations. But even though it always focusing on the underdeveloped countries, because on the basis of the underdeveloped countries improvement only, the International Monetary Fund also will be improved. So the World Bank provides long-term loans for various development projects. So what are the projects or what are the functions is there mean? The investment for the productive purposes. The World Bank performs the functions of assisting in the reconstruction and development of territories of membership nations through facility of investment for the productive purposes. This World Bank always lending the or providing the financial facilities for their member nations only for their productive purposes. So all the nations also as some of the industries or some of the sectors as a productive purposes. So it also will make the investment for the productive purposes for their member nations. It also encourages the development of productive facilities and resources in less developed countries. So these organizations encourage the less developed countries for the productive facilities. Next, balanced growth of international trade. Promoting the long-range balanced growth of trade at international level and the maintaining equilibrium in balance of payments of member nations by encouraging international investment. So when they are providing the financial facilities for all their nations, member nations, so the balanced growth of international trade will occur. So otherwise, if there is no financial facilities by this international bank or the World Bank, so some of the inequality will be erased among the nations. Next, provisions of loans and guarantees. So arranging the loans or providing guarantees on loans by various other channels so as to execute important projects. So the World Bank always providing the guarantees or the loans because of executing the important projects. Some of the projects always required high amount of capitals. But if the nations are not having the sufficient level of the capital, so the World Bank always helpful to them. And because of that, it will helpful to encourage their execute important projects. Next, promotion of foreign private investment. The promotion of private foreign investment by means of guarantees and loans and other investment made by private investors. So World Bank always encouraging the private investors to the underdeveloping countries and the developing countries. So because of that, all the underdeveloping countries and the developing countries also can have the possibilities to absorbing the foreign direct investment by the private investors. The bank supplements private investment by providing finance for productive purpose out of its own resources or from borrowed funds. So this bank also supplements the private investment by providing the finance for productive purposes. From where it will be providing mean, how it will be providing mean, as we have studied already, it will provide from its own fund, otherwise from the borrowed funds. Next, technical services. The World Bank facilitates the different kinds of technical services to the member countries through staff, college and experts. So these nations also provide the staff, colleagues and the experts to the underdeveloping countries. So the experts also can give the practice or the training for the labor and the executive persons in these underdeveloping countries. So the technical services also will be increased. So the five functions are there along with the IBRD. Next, achievements of World Bank. So what are the achievements are achieved by the World Bank? So the World Bank is to be successful in achieving its primary objective of reconstruction and development of war-ravaged nations. So as per their objectives of the World Bank, it was successful to achieving its primary objective to reconstruction and development of war-ravaged nations. So it helped greatly in the reconstruction of Europe after the World War II. It has been providing the developed and developing countries the same treatment in the process of growth. So all the nations without any disparity. So the World Bank providing many financial facilities to all their member nations. So it is noted that the bank's membership has increased from the initial number of 30 countries to 68 countries in 1960s and to 151 countries in 1988. So when the beginning of the World Bank, so the member nations was 30 to 68 countries only in 1960s. So after that, within the particular period 1988, the membership countries has increased abundantly, around 151 countries. So 151 countries are became as a membership in this World Bank. So the IBRD has 180 member countries now. Next, the bank grants medium and long term loans for reconstruction and development purposes to the member countries. So normally all the nations also will be in the need of having the loan facilities, but in the same time it has to repay the fund within the particular time. So the World Bank provides the medium and long term loans for the purpose of reconstruction and development. So what are the nations also being in the need of reconstructions, it can use their financial assistance. The actual term of a loan depends upon the estimated useful life of the equipment of planned finance. Third one, initially the World Bank's loans were mainly directed at the European countries for financing their programs of reconstruction. So later it changed its development loan strategy and lays more emphasis on financing schemes for the poor masses of the
developing countries. So it has changed their development loan strategy, and it has more emphasis of financial scheme for the poor mass of the developing countries. For then, the World Bank grants loans to member countries only for productive purposes, particularly for agricultural, irrigation, power and transport. So without these four factors, we cannot establish any of the industrial sectors. So the World Bank always focusing to providing the more financial for the productive purposes, only for the agricultural. So otherwise, the bank strengthens the infrastructure needed for further development. Next, the International Development Associations, the soft loan window of the bank provides loans to underdeveloping countries at very low rate of interest. So when they are borrowing the money from the World Bank at a very low rate of interest, it can easily repay to the World Bank. So however, the economic inequality among the member countries goes on increasing. Many African countries are yet to improve their economic status. So but because it is their scarcity of resources, natural resources. Next, India and the World Bank. The relationship, otherwise, how the India was got the relations with the World Bank, and because of that, how it was improved. So the name International Bank for Reconstruction and Development was first suggested by India to drafting committees. So drafting committee is important. So the World Bank first suggested by India to the drafting committees. Since then, the two have developed a close relationship with each other, from framing the policies of economic development in India to the economic. So the World Bank has given large financial assistance to India for economic development. So not only that, a special mention may be made of the assistance World Bank has given to India in the development of infrastructure such as electric power, transport, communications, irrigation projects and steel industries. And the World Bank has assisted a number of projects in India only. The World Bank has also assisted India in accelerating programs of poverty alleviation and economic development. So what are the programs have to be taken by the India to eliminate the poverty alleviation is suggested by World Bank only. So until China became the member of World Bank in 1980, India was the largest beneficiary of the World Bank assistance. After that, the China became the first place. Next, the World Trade Organizations. So simply we will call the WTO. The WTO, the World Trade Organizations, was established in 1995 as a successor to the GATT. It is a new international organization set up as permanent body, and it is designed to play the role of watchdog in the spheres of trade in goods and services, foreign investments and intellectual property rights. The Dungal Draft. The Dungal Draft only formulated by the Arthur Dungal. So in the because of this Dungal Draft only, the WTO was established. Its Secretary General became the basis for the World Trade Organization. So what are the objectives of World Trade Organizations? First, the basic aim is to expand international trade and bring about economic prosperity by liberalizing the trade restrictions. So if the globalizations want to become as a seamless or otherwise extend the international trade, have to liberalizing the trade restrictions. So because of that, the World Trade Organization has some of the objectives. First one is to ensure reduction of tariff and other barriers. So what are the barriers were there? It was reduced, and some of the amount of tariff. So if you are reducing the tariff, so all the nations also can expand their international trade. So the World Trade Organization has one of the objective to ensure the reduction of tariff and other barriers. Otherwise, next one, to eliminate the discriminations in trade. Some of the discriminations also bring the nations as a insufficient or unable. So now the World Bank and some of the other international financial organizations also got some of the differentiations or the discriminations to providing their financial facilities. But the World Trade Organizations got one of the objectives to eliminate the discriminations in trade. Next, to facilitate higher standard of living. So all the nation's peoples must have the higher standard of living. So the World Trade Organizations also achieved in this matter. Next, to enable the lower divisions countries or lower developing countries to secure fair share in the growth of international trade. So all the nations must have some of the fair shares in the growth of international trade. Next, to ensure linkage between trade policies, environmental policies and sustainable development. So the World Trade Organization only make the ensure the linkage between the trade policies, environmental policies and sustainable development. In these three policies, we must make some of the linkages, because whenever we have increased in this trade, our environmental will be polluted, and because of that the sustainable development also will be damaged. So if you are making the linkage between these three policies, we can bring the sustainable growth with the good environmental. Next, WTO agreements. The World Trade Organizations brought up some of the agreements. So what are the agreements are made by the World Trade Organizations mean? First, agreement on trade related intellectual properties rights. Simply we will say TRIPS. The intellectual property rights include copyright, trademarks, patent, geographical indications, trade secrets, industrial designs, etc. So the TRIPS agreement provides for granting product patents instead of process patents. So instead of process patents, if you are giving the product patent, so the nations also will have some of the particular rights for their productions. So the period of protection will be 20 years for patents, 50 years for copyrights, 7 years for trademarks and 10 years for layout designs. If you are giving some of the certificates or the agreements or the license, so it has some of the rights. Next, agreement on trade related investment measures. Simply we will call the TRIMS. The TRIMS are related to conditions or restrictions in respect of foreign investment in the countries. So whenever making the investment, the foreign investment, so the TRIPS or the trade related investment measures will be protecting. It calls for introducing equal treatment for foreign companies on par with national companies. So TRIMS were widely employed by developing countries. So restrictions on foreign investment on some of the matters. So So no restrictions on area of investment. So because of the things, all the nations also got the rights to make the investment on any area. There is no restrictions on area of investment. Next, no binding on use of local materials. So we can get all the local materials for the productive purposes. Next, no mandatory exports. Next, no restrictions, repatriations of royalty, dividend and interest. Next, no trade balancing requirements. Next, agreement on agriculture. The agricultural was included for the first time under GATT. The important aspect of the agreement are tariffications, tariff cuts and subsidy reductions. So the World Trade Organization also got one of the agreement here. The important aspect, the tariffications and tariff cut and subsidy reductions. Some of the subsidies also was reduced and the tariff also cuts. Next, dispute settlement body. The dispute settlement body puts an end to procedural delays. So what are the problems were arised? So this World Bank, so the World Trade Organizations act as a dispute settlement. And the settlement body also puts an end to the procedural delays. So without any delays, it bringing some of the solves. It is mandatory to settle any dispute within 18 months. Okay, students, I think it's enough. If you have any doubt, please ask me.